My name is Alex Curtin, and I'm a DevOps manager at Unity. Unity is the world's leading platform for creating and operating interactive, real-time 3D content. Our platform provides a comprehensive set of software solutions to create and operate content for mobile phones, tablets, PCs, consoles, and AR or VR devices. After a real-time 3D experience is launched, we power developers to grow and monetize their game through Unity Ads, serving more than 23 billion ads per month on over 2.5 billion devices. When Unity first migrated to GCP, we built an open source Redis solution using GCE VMs and a home-rolled Terraform module for clustered or sentinel mode Redis that lived outside of Kubernetes. This required advanced init scripts, firewall rules, console for service discovery, and even more complexities. One of the largest issues with our earlier attempts at providing Redis for developers was the difficulty level involved at creating new Redis clusters with the Terraform module. The solution required an in-depth knowledge of all of the moving parts. For example, understanding how console and sentinel were involved. The large scale of Redis clusters built this way also translated into almost a full-time team member being devoted to assisting with buildouts or issues with existing clusters. At the time, there was not a reliable way to run persistent databases inside Kubernetes. We wanted to provide a standardized solution for Redis on GKE, but one that would be reliable, scalable, and include an enterprise support team we can count on. That's when we first started taking a look at Redis Enterprise and the Redis Enterprise operator for GKE. The DevOps team started experimenting with the operator and were amazed at how resilient it was and how it fit right in with our existing toolset of GKE, Helm, and Terraform, as well as including monitoring and alerting with Prometheus. Moving to Redis Enterprise and the operator for GKE allowed us to enable development teams to spin up new Redis databases through YAML manifests, remove the worry and overhead around node management, allowed for swift failover with less client disruption, and additionally, to eliminate Sentinel for high availability. As an added bonus, our client code did not need to change. We could use Redis Enterprise as a drop-in replacement for the legacy open source Redis databases. Running Redis Enterprise in GKE alongside the services also reduced developer friction in the time it takes to get tests, staging, and production infrastructure set up. What used to take a few days can now be easily accomplished in one single day. As part of the DevOps team's push for standardization around best-in-class solutions, we'll be moving more and more workloads into Redis Enterprise as the de facto solution for Redis at Unity.